Welcome to the Terror Dome in New Orleans, Louisiana, where it is never safe to go out in public on Fat Tuesday.
Why is that, Grim?
That's because Tuesday's when they have to lure the zombies back into the stadium, so they let a few fat people out to lead them back inside. You know, a little bait. And this is going to be a bloody game. The teams are loading their weapons and sharpening their spikes. The Purple Mutant Eaters go up against the New Orleans Zombies. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. It's game day here on the MFL Network, and we are just about to get underway. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzrow, along with Brickhead Mulligan.
Hi.
Any thoughts on today's game?
No, not really. Kind of flatlining right now in the thoughts department. Hey, can you help me get this pencil out of my ear? It's stuck worse than it was the last time.
Yeah, you idiot. And it's first and ten. Shouldn't be easy, but with kickers, you never know. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. First and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
And the defense just knocked the wind out of that quarterback.
Yo, seriously, man, you think you go toe-to-toe with me? I will wreck your world. You understand me, Junior? I'll wreck your world.
Second down in a very lot.
Hot one, hot two.
Just burned the defense pretty hard on that one.
Man, it's still edible, though. Just gotta scrape off the charred parts.
Third down and eight.
Hot one, hot two.
The offense is pretty much unstoppable when they use their beast boost injection. Close your eyes, Briggs. This is gonna get ugly fast. No doubt about it, that guy is dead. He says, I'm taking you with me. I don't remember that being an officially sanctioned MFL rule. And it's first and ten. Defense had enough with this rep and jumps off sides to kill him. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
And he breaks away. And he picks up about six on the play. And that'll be second down and four.
Hot one, hot two.
And the defense just called the ginormous dirty trick.
His big ass will probably.
His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. And this guy has quite the female following. Listen to them.
Yeah, they all want to jump his bones.
I wish the middle linebacker would have jumped his bones. I just lost a sawbuck on that play.
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. It's good. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. Receiver's pocket, and the defense gets a turnover.
You can't keep a good mutant down.
He refuses to go down.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
First and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
Oh, with the brutal hit. Second down and six. I don't know whose eyes the QB is using, but can we get him some new ones? Oh, that's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutant meat.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. And it's first and ten. He had nowhere to go and got nothing out of it. Second down and 10. At this point, with multiple interceptions, the QB should just throw in the towel.
Yeah, he's probably having an interception, though.
Holy crap, he runs straight into a mutant trap and dies. Reminds me of my breakfast cereal, the old Nut Crunch. First and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
And the back gets in there and swats the ball away.
He can't catch, but he sure can swat.
Second down and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
And he gets 3 yards on that run. And that'll bring up third down and seven.
Hot one.
I've had it. I'm running out of excuses for this QB. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's going to have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. And it's first and ten. And that's a run for no gain.
Then it's not really a run, is it?
Second down and 10. That pass was way off target, but I'm pretty sure the QB will blame the receiver as he always does. Third down and 10. The way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 yards on that play. And they'll line up for the punt here. Nice punt. Should move him back nicely. He's got the ball now and is going to try and score. And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. First and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
first and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
Second down and a lot.
Hot one, hot two.
That ball was almost intercepted. Third down and long.
Hot one, hot two.
Running for a couple of yards. Well, here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on here. And he just lets that one go. He says, no, thank you, and the defense downs it. And so at the end of one, we're all tied up. We'll be right back. Second and three. He just put that guy out of his misery and says, who's next? He's at the 40. He's at the 30. He's at the 20. And he runs out of gas and got tackled short of the goal line. Hell of a run, though.
A lot of stamina happens to a lot of guys, Glenn. At least that's what I hear.
And it's first and 10. Oh, man, what a throw. That pass is for a touchdown. You know, the league used to flag this for excessive celebration. You know, refs really don't want to get too close to the rabid, roided-out monsters. And don't even get me started on the werewolf. Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sinners then.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. And it's first and 10. That's a catch for a 10-yard gain. Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. Like he just ran into the line at the DMV.
And guess what?
Oh, man, he just went off the rails of a crazy train and murdered that guy.
Yeah.
Gotta love it.
He should bite his head off for an encore, Grim.
The offense is running low on quarterbacks. They have only 2 left. They might consider running the ball more. And it's first and 10.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
Oh, mama. Just call him Cap'n Crunch. Another one bites the dust. And it's first and 10. Right running like he had a load in his pants. Picks up maybe two.
We always ran with a load in our pants, Grim. It's a pretty good defensive tool. Except the zombies. They are freaks.
Void rage. Because if you can't answer your question with violence, ask another. Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. Straight through the uprights. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond.
Hit in the head with a bulldog, Grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
Hot one, hot two.
Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. Second down and nine.
Hot one, hot two.
About a 6-yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. If my parole officer calls, I was with you last night, Bricks.
No problem. I spent the night in lockup for solicitation.
Hot one, hot two. Hot.
And they stack the line, and he gets his bell rung for a yard. You know, sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get a return. He's got the ball now. Let's see. Oh, and that one's going to hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. And it's first and ten. Great play by the defense. It's not too often a quarterback gets rejected.
That's why that's the position I originally tried out for. I want to know what it's like for other people to accept you.
Now that went from a joke to making me feel feelings. Stop it. This isn't a place to feel feelings. This is football. One potato, two potato, three potato, four. The defense just blew up a player who thought he was going to score. Oh, that hot potato dirty trick gets him every time. And it's first and ten. Minutes left in the half. Second down and more than the QB would like. Oh no, it's a sticky ball dirty trick. The defense pretty much turned the ball into a yo-yo of doom.
Did you ever think you'd say that, Grim? A yo-yo of doom?
No, my friend, I didn't. I love this job. Under 2 minutes of timeout means the QB is playing beat the clock, and he better win. Third down, and the punter is warming up. And that's another pick. Man, oh man, the defense is going to have more reception. This guy's a brick shithouse. Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks? And the ref just called a bullshit penalty. Third down and six. It's a jailbreak. And the defense jumps offside to kill the ref. Ho ho! Crowd's loving it. And it's first and ten. Wrestles away from that, and like Bricks' bowels, he is loose. today, folks. These teams have bad blood between them. Apparently, they got it from the same bloodmobile that usually parks outside next to the taco truck. Raccoon rabies blood is my thought. Always a player's favorite. First and 8 to go. I don't remember calling 911, but the SWAT team is out in full force at the line of scrimmage. Nice play by the lineman. And that'll be 2nd and 8 to go. It's 2-yard run before he stopped. Time to speed things up, and they take their last time out.
It's between them and the clock now, Grim.
Well, and the defense, too. The offense goes into their 2-minute drill.
What the hell is that?
It's the same thing in the hurry-up offense, you moron.
And he zips that one in there for a touchdown. Can't tell if this is a seizure or a celebration. Either way, the fans are loving it. You know, this shouldn't be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's 1st and 10.
Hot 1, hot 2.
He picks up 5 on that play. And they stop the clock with their first timeout to try and stay in this game.
Oh, nice coaching move there. Hall of Fame caliber.
Well, I mean, it's a pretty standard coaching move at this point of the game.
I won't listen to this blasphemy.
Card. I only need one more.
The quarterback is controlling the clock right now like the clock is into it.
He just clock blocked the clock.
And it's 1st and 10.
Hot 1, hot 2, hot 3.
And that catch will give them a 1st down.
I don't know if the hands, but he sure has a good set of hands.
And that'll be their final timeout. I'd be impressed if he splits the uprights from this far away, Bricks.
If he doesn't, they're gonna split his skull wide open.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
It's a close battle as the quarter ends. Halftime is brought to you by those caring folks at Monsanto Industries. They make the world a better place by making the government tell you it is. It's anyone's game as the third quarter begins. Both teams have taken their performance-enhancing drugs, and everyone is ready to rock and roll. The teams line up for the 2nd half kickoff. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Oh, and that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice, Grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own.
too.
And there's another pick. Man, this quarterback must have learned a lot about shearing.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yawn.
And it's first and ten. And the defense gives him 5 yards there. Second down and five. And the quarterback threads the needle for a first down. The offense lost another running back and only two remain on their roster. When a team loses all their running backs, they lose their ability to run the ball.
Yeah, like if I rip out your tongue, you won't be able to speak. Tell us something we don't know, genius.
First down and seven. Boom to the moon! Another loser bites the dust. In the NFL, winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
It was total carnage today, folks. A gruesome and bloody mess with a high death toll. And the hometown fans love it. Way to go, guys. The New Orleans Zombies win by forfeit.
I'm traumatized, Grim. I don't think I'll ever be able to eat SpaghettiOs again.
There's not much left of the opposition, and the fans are loving it. There was only one way this game was going to end, and that was in a forfeit.
That's not quite true, Grim. An alien spacecraft could have crashed into the stadium and ended the game. How about it?
How about if you shut the hell up right now? We go down to the field and listen to what the MVP has to say. Blitzro with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's final game stats are brought to you by the Micro Heart Corporation. They get it right every up.